Okay, ladies and gentlemen, we're on our way to the abandoned Aerojet rocket factory here in the Florida Everglades. Right now I'm headed, you could say southwestbound on Highway 9336. And we're coming up on Southwest 232nd Avenue, which is going to be right here. And hopefully it is opened. Ah, oh, man. Okay. Yeah, this is used right now by the South Florida Water Management District. It's rarely opened. As you can see, there's one of their trucks right there. So what I'm going to do is, a couple of years ago, I came when this road was still accessible. And I took some pictures. So I'm going to go ahead and share them with you guys. In the 1950s, the USSR was one of two superpowers in this world. And in 1957, they launched Sputnik, the first man-made object to orbit the Earth. Then in 1962, they planted missiles in Cuba, which did not make the United States happy. These are going to be space images taken of all the missiles put in Cuba. So the U.S. realized they had to do something to counteract this measure. But then in 1963, the United States Air Force gave Aerojet, a major rocket and missile manufacturer, $3 million to create this test site and manufacturing site in Homestead. Here we see there are six compounds. They even built a canal so they can transport the missiles by barge up the canal, which was the only way that they would be transported. They even had to build a drawbridge over US-1 so that they can be transported and vehicular traffic could open. This was a picture of the drawbridge. There's the bridge tender's house. This is a picture of the drawbridge when it was in existence. They knocked it down like in 2008. It was there, and you can see the bridge tender's house on your right there. Here's the first compound. You see a tree growing on the roof. That's how old it's been there. This place is full of alligators and panthers. I luckily didn't encounter any, but yeah, they do live in these areas. It's all surrounded by Everglades. There's actually a rocket still in the ground on this site. There it is. That rocket is still there as we speak. If you go, you can see this rocket. I promise you. This is one of the compounds. I don't know. There's no signs. There's barely any signs left, so I don't know what exactly they did in this one. But yeah, here's one. Here is another one. This one seemed like it was used for storage with the, you can see the big rusted barn doors on the side. And here you can see that there's no walls left, it's just the partitions and some insulation on the far wall there on the back. This is another shot of the rocket that's still in the ground. Scary that that thing is still there as we speak. If it fell into the wrong hands. This is a hallway. I'm guessing that was like research and development rooms on either side. I don't know what this is. This is, could have been storage as well. There you see a meter off to your left and how the dirt has accumulated over the years and the rust on the walls. You can see trees growing on that wall. Those trees have been there for decades, I'm guessing. This place got abandoned, I think it was in 1969 when NASA decided to go with liquid-fueled engines. So then all the workers here got laid off, and that caused the abandonment of the facility. But between 1965 and 1967, you had multiple test firings done, and one of them was at night. There was one that you could even see from Miami, which is like 60 miles away. It produced over 3 million pounds of thrust. One problem, though, was near the burnout phase, the rocket nozzle was ejected, causing the propellant made of hydrochloric acid to be spread across the wetlands in the Everglades and crop fields and homes in Homestead. So many of the residents complained about the damage, which included pain to their cars and killing thousands of dollars worth of crops. So, yeah, that could have been a big issue in the abandonment of this plant. All the side effects it caused. After the abandonment, Aerojet sued the state of Florida and sold most of its land to the South Dade Land Corporation for $6 million. After many unsuccessful attempts to use the land for farming, it was sold off again to the state of Florida for $12 million. This here is the parking lot. That's what you see when you first go in. And then Aerojet would later trade its remaining 5,100 acres in South Florida for 5,500 acres in New Mexico. This is still there as well. Please subscribe or like. I hope you enjoyed the video, guys. Take care. Over and out.